Today we're going to be installing the Stealth Hitches towing conversion kit on my Kia EV6. I appreciate your patience with waiting for this video. I know some of you have been waiting for a few weeks. I wanted to make sure though that the Stealth Hitches website was updated with their new active harness. This is the wiring harness from Kia that they actually modified to make it work a little bit better for you guys with the Stealth Hitches trailer hitch. But I wanted to make sure you had that option before I posted the video. That way you guys can make sure you get the best one for you. The towing conversion kit includes the chain hooks, as well as the towing adapter and ball mount, and the wiring harness. Should hopefully be an easy install, so let's get the car on the ramps and get started. All right, so we'll go ahead and take off this gravel guard. All right, next up, we're gonna go ahead and remove those 5-inch bolts and nuts and install the chain hooks with the new nuts. All right, so we'll go ahead and install the chain hooks on here. You do want to make sure that you put the side on that has the lever before you try and put it up in there. And they should be oriented like this, with this kind of going towards the front of the vehicle. Now I will torque this to 150 foot-pounds. All right, that's nice and tight. Now we'll go ahead and check the fit of the gravel guard and go from there. So checking the fit of the gravel guard with these chain hooks installed, it does block it from going all the way up, so I am going to need to notch them out with the Dremel. So I'll do that right now. All right, I got those notches in the gravel guard, so let's go ahead and test that fit now. All right, third time's a charm. Do this. There we go. Now that should work. So we'll go ahead and put these pins back in and that nut on. It should be good to go. All right, so it is all in, push pins are in, and we are good to go. All right, next up, we're gonna go ahead and install the tow ball onto the hitch mount here. Just slides right through, the lock washer underneath, the nut. Tighten her up.
All right, so now we'll go ahead and install the towing attachment. First, let me go ahead and unlock it. So, got the key here. Locked, can lift up the lever, and now it is ready for the towing attachment to be inserted. And it locks into place. It's very sturdy. You can go ahead and push the lock in. That locks it so it can't come out. Put the cover back on it, and we are good to go. The lever is down, and that's it. Everything looks good, fits good, clearances are good, doesn't touch the car, and it should work great for towing. Let's go ahead and get the car off these ramps and take a look at it on the ground. So this is what it looks like on the ground. Everything looks good, clearances look good, ground clearance is solid, and we have a nice rise here. I believe it's about 7 inches. Ground clearance is about 8 inches to the bottom there, and to where you mount, it's about 15. So overall, very solid, fairly easy to install the towing conversion portion of it. Next up is the wiring harness. All right, so I got the wiring harness out here. You can see the various pieces and connection points here. This is the Kia wiring harness that Stealth Hitches actually modifies and installs this magnet on, so that way it stays up and out of the way, and it works really well with the Stealth Hitches trailer hitch. And let's get it installed. On the side here, there is an access panel that we can use to get to the wiring and everything that we need to. So we'll go ahead and pop that out. So the access panel can be kind of tight. You just kind of take a flathead screwdriver, pry it open, and then pop it down. If it is tight, just work at it and it'll eventually pop loose. And then we have access to the wiring and everything down in here. So I'll give you a little bit better view of the wiring here inside the access panel. So that down there is what we are going to be connecting to. Now it may be taped down, so we'll just kind of pull that tape loose, and then we should easily be able to access what we need to connect everything. And there is a grommet down there, right there, that we will go ahead and take loose, and then the new wiring includes a new grommet, and it'll just feed up from the bottom right there. So I got the tape loose, and you can see the connector here. And that'll fit directly in with the wiring harness that we have. So before we do anything with wiring, we're gonna go under the hood here, and we are going to disconnect the negative cable from the battery, just to make sure there are no issues when we are plugging in. So to do that, we take this cover off. And to take the cover off, we just kind of pull up on this piece, and it will come right out. And now we can easily access that negative cable to take that loose and make sure we isolate it so that it doesn't come back into contact while we're working on things. Alright, so I got my 10mm socket here, and we will go ahead and take this loose. So now that is moved and off to the side, and it won't come back into contact, so we should be good to go. So next up, we'll go ahead and remove the grommet that the wiring is going to feed through. And that is right here towards the front of the vehicle. And we just pull that out, and now we have easy access. Now we will go ahead and take the wiring. We got the 6-pin end here. This has the grommet built in, so we will feed that up. We'll feed that up into the hole so that we can access it from above. And we will get the grommet seated here in place. Easiest way to do that is to kind of push the whole thing through and then wiggle it around, make sure it's in there good, and we are good to go. Now we'll go ahead and make the connections up top and then arrange the wiring down here. All right, so I have the wiring that I fed through right here. This is the pre-wiring that my car came with since I have the Wind Edition. The Wind and the GT line should come with the pre-wiring automatically, so this should work out very easily for the installation here. And then we'll just go ahead and make the necessary connections. So the first connection we will make is with the factory harness into this harness that they supplied with the towing kit. This just fits right in. Push it in until you hear a click. Make sure it's secure. And that part is all set. The next connection we will make is with the 7-pin connector here into the control module. So the control module has a 7-pin connection and a 6-pin connection. This one will go into the 7-pin connection. Seated good. You can feel there's a clip right here. You can feel when that locks in place. And now we're good to go there. Now the last connection we will make is with the control module and the 6-pin harness that we pushed up from down below. Slides right in. And similar to the last one, you can feel when it kind of clips in place. And that's it. Those are all the connections. Now we'll go ahead and get it zip tied all out of the way.
So what I'm going to do is actually go ahead and get some double-sided tape installed and install the module right here. Should fit nicely there and allow everything to be kept back out of the way and no rattling. So here's the double-sided tape that they provided installed on the module. I'll go ahead and get that placed in there and secured. And here's everything all secured. I went ahead and did zip ties right here to connect all the wiring together and provide easy access to that fuse. And then back here, if I can get in here, you can see the module. And that is placed there with some double-sided tape, and it's very secure. I'm not worried at all about it coming out, and it looks good. So now we'll go underneath and get the wiring taken care of down there.
All right, so next up we're going to route the cable underneath the vehicle around the trailer hitch here, and we are going to use zip ties to mount it on top of the hitch and then run it over here, and then we will use this magnet to secure it on the hitch somewhere. So it is all zip tied in now. I got it zip tied to that other wiring up there on the side, and then I used a couple of zip ties to connect it to the trailer hitch itself, and then I've got the excess routed up underneath that bracket, so it'll be nice in the gravel guard and provide enough excess for connections, and the front is secured with that magnet. Should work out well.
Got the gravel guard back on, everything's in place nicely. Got the wiring here with plenty of slack for when I need to use it. And when I'm not using it, I can just tuck it back in place and use that fancy magnet to attach it to one of the metal pieces in here. I think I'll probably like it right there on the tow hooks. Fits nicely. No pressure on it, and that keeps it up out of the way. And there we go.
So now I'll go ahead and tighten down the 12 volt battery. Make sure that is on good. Then we'll go ahead and reinstall this cover. Reinstall it the right way. It just kind of goes straight down into place. And we are good to go. Charging cable back in here. Close everything down. And we will go ahead and get the car off the ramps. So I'm really excited to get everything tested out. The installation went well for the towing kit and the wiring harness. Everything looks good. Should function well. Make sure you guys stay tuned. I'll be doing a video testing out all the features, all the different options that now are going to be in the infotainment system since there's a trailer wiring harness installed. I'll also be doing a video testing out the towing itself, towing a small boat, so you can see how that functionality works. But let me know if you guys have any questions in the meantime. That video should be up within the next couple days, so I will see you guys in that video, and thank you for watching.